Let us start this question. The diagram shows a sector of a circle of radius 8 centimeter. The angle of the sector x, the perimeter of the sector is 16 minus 14 by centimeter. Find the value of x. Find the value of x. Again, perimeter of the circle, perimeter of the sector means the radius plus the arc lengths. Radius plus the arc lengths. So to find the x perimeter was equal to 2 multiplied by 8 plus the length of the sector, which is the length of the arc, which is theta divided by 360 multiplied by 2 pi r. This perimeter, which is 16 plus 14 pi, will equal to 2 multiplied by 8 plus theta is x divided by 360 multiplied by 2 pi multiplied by 8. 8 is the radius of, 8 is the radius of the circle. So 2 multiplied by 8 is 16, and here 16, so 16 will go 16. Now 14 pi and 2 pi multiplied by 8, so pi will go pi. Two, so the remaining, let us find this theta, sine x. X is equal to 14 multiplied by 360 divided by 2 multiplied by 8. So let us find the answer. 14 multiplied by 360 divided by 2 multiplied by 8. So 315 is the angle x. Again, in this question, perimeter. Perimeter means not the arc length. Perimeter means the two radius plus the arc length. The two radius plus the arc length. Let us see this question. A spacecraft made 58,376 orbit of the Earth and traveled a distance of 2.656 multiplied by 10 power 9 kilometers. Calculate the distance traveled in one orbit correct to the nearest kilometer. This is the number of the orbit that he did, the spacecraft, and this is the distance total that he move. So the total distance divided by the orbit will give us the distance in one orbit. So d, which is the distance, is equal to 2.656 power 9 divided by 58376. Give us the distance in kilometers per one orbit. So 2.656 power 9 divided by the number of the orbit, which is 58376. This is the distance per one orbit in kilometers. So 4, 5, 4, 9, 8. And to kilometer, so no need for any digit. No need for any digit. The orbit of a spacecraft is a circle. Calculate the radius of the orb. So this is the perimeter. We need what? We need the radius. So perimeter will be pi 2 pi r. The perimeter will be 2 pi r. So this perimeter, 45,498, will equal to 2 pi r. So r, which is radius, is equal to this answer divided by 2 divided by pi. So the radius is 7241. This is the radius. This is the radius of the orbit. The radius of the Earth at the equator is approximately 6.4 power 6 meters. Calculate the circumference of the Earth at quarter. Give your answer in a standard form correct to two significant figures. So two significant figures. You need what? Circumference of the Earth. So perimeter or circumference would be 2 pi r. So it will be 2 multiplied by pi. Multiplied by, this is the radius, so 6.4 power 6. So let us see, 2 multiplied by shift y, 6.4 power 6. So the answer, 40. 40 power 6, and again it's two significant figure, so only 40 multiplied by 10 power 6. This is here the perimeter. 40, two significant figure, so 40 power 6. Let us see this question. A circle radius 8.5 centimeter correct to the nearest 0.1 centimeter. So it would be 0.1 divided by 2, 0.05. The lower boundary of the area of the circle is b by centimeter square. The upper boundary of the area of the circle is q by centimeter square. Find the value of b and q. So now I have a radius area with a radius 8.5. So lower boundary 8.5 minus 0.05. The upper boundary 8.5 plus 0.05. So here 8.45, here 8.55. This is the upper boundary of the radius and this is the lower boundary of the radius. So area is equal to pi r squared. So area lower boundary will equal to pi 8.45 squared. So it will be 8.45 square equal to 71.4 pi. This value for the lower boundary, so for the lower boundary B, B, this value will be B. So 71.4. Now let us find the Q. Let us find the Q. Same process, area now upper will equal to by multiplied by 8.55 squared. So it will be 8.55 squared equal to 53.1. So 73.1 by this value now will be Q. So 73.1. This is Q. Okay. Let us go ahead to another question. The circle arc has radius of 3 meters. And the center O. So this is radius 3 and the center is O. AB horizontal and horizontal and the angle AO. So AB is horizontal and the angle AOB is AOB is equal to 120. During a storm, the tunnel filled with water to the level shown by the shaded area in the diagram. Calculate the shaded area. Calculate the shaded area. This area consists of the half of the circle or semi-circle, which is this circle, minus a sector. Let me complete the circle here. The semicircle minus the semicircle minus the sector here, this one will give us minus this one, will give us the area shaded that he need. So let us write the equation. Area is equal to the half of the circle, which is half pi r square. This is the area of the semicircle. Minus, now the area of the sector. Area of the sector again, or area of the segment. Area of segment, not sector. Area of this area of this segment. So it will be the area of the sector theta divided by 360 by minus the triangle area, which is sine theta divided by 2 r squared. Okay, so area will equal to half by 3 squared minus 120 divided by 360 multiplied by y minus sine 120 divided by 2 multiplied by 3 square. Let us bring the calculator. It will be 0.5 multiplied by y multiplied by 3 square minus 120 divided by 360 multiplied by y minus sine 120 close the bracket divided by 2 close the bracket multiplied by 3 square and then finally close the bracket. It will be 8.61. 8.61. So the area is equal to 8.61 meters square. Let us go ahead to another question. A circular lake in the natural reserve has radius of 45 meters. Calculate the area of the lake. So circular lake, radius 45. So area is pi r squared. So it will be pi 45 squared. So pi multiplied by 45 squared. So equal to 6362 by 62, because again 0.7, so the 7 will increase the 1 by 2. So 6362. A fence is placed along part of the circumference of the lake. This arc subtends at an angle of 210 at the center of the circle. Calculate the length of the fence. Length of the arc, take into consideration the radius is 45. So arc length L will equal to theta divided by 360 multiplied by 2 pi r. So 210 divided by 360 multiplied by 2 multiplied by 45 multiplied by 1. So let me write 210 multiplied by 2 multiplied by y multiplied by 45 divided by 360. So the length is 165. This is the length of the fence.